Hey guys, and welcome back to my channel. It's me, Eva, and today I'm going to be showing you guys my February vlog. So first, we're going to be talking about the books that I read this month. So on my channel, you've heard me talk about music, merch, and Taylor Swift, but something I haven't really talked about that is a huge part of my identity is I love reading. I love literature, I love writing, and I just love absorbing myself in books and everything that comes with that. The first book that I read this month was Ernest Hemingway's A Farewell to Arms. So this book was actually my first Hemingway, and I got it for free at my school. A Farewell to Arms is basically a World War I romance, and it's very interesting. Honestly, it was a great book. I'm really happy I read this. There were so many great quotes in here. It was a very interesting read, a very interesting perspective. The ending was sad, but I definitely recommend it. So at my school, I'm part of the Lit Society, which is basically just a fancy name for book club. But our February pick was Franny and Zoe, and this was my first Salinger book, and wow, this was something else. Also, sorry for the copy, it's very battered. This was my mother's, but it is my mother's, I just borrowed it. But basically, this book is very interesting. If you don't know about it, it is basically a two-part novella, and the first part is about Franny and the second part is about Zoe, and they're part of the fictional Glass family. And it basically is just really a complex story about covering things from like spiritualism to conformity and just the identity of a person. And honestly, it was a lot to unpack. This was a very deep read, and I definitely am going to be rereading this in the future because I did understand quite a bit of it, but I didn't understand all of it, and I think a lot of that comes with age as well, but it was very good. I definitely enjoyed what I did understand, and there was just amazing quotes in here, amazing points, and honestly, I thought this was a great book. There's so much to unpack in this little 200-page book, so very good. The third book I read this month was Agatha Christie's A Crooked House, and I got this for free at my school too. I got a lot of free books at my school, but it was just a little mystery that was very good. It was very fast-paced, and I definitely enjoyed this. Basically, it's about a grandfather of this like big family with a huge estate that gets poisoned, and it's basically just unraveling that. It's a great read. I just wanted something kind of quick and light. I mean, obviously murder isn't light, but easy to read after Franny and Zoe, and this was that. So this was a pretty good book, and I enjoyed this. Okay, so now we're gonna be talking about the music that I listened to this month. So, as always, obviously I listen to Taylor Swift because there has not been a month in my life that I haven't listened to Taylor Swift. But I was really enjoying Folklore this month. I think this was a very folklore-y month for me. But other than that, because I'm not just going to talk about Taylor Swift this entire video, I also listened to a lot of Lana Del Rey this month. I've been getting into her music a lot lately, and I think this month I was really exploring her discography. And honestly, I'd have to say right now my favorites are, I've really been listening to just the entire Ultraviolence album a lot. The album is so good. Just honestly, she has so much good music. So I've been really just like exploring all the different albums, and I found a lot of great songs I really like. And it's just been a really good month for Lana this month. And then I've also, of course, been listening to The Smiths, which is my favorite band. And I've been listening to some older music too, like some Velvet Underground, and really just exploring a lot of different music this month. So I feel like this was a good month for music. Okay guys, so we just talked about my favorite books that I read this month, or the books I read this month, and my favorite music from this month, and now we're just going to be talking about my top 10 favorite things overall this month. So So it is not really in any particular order. I'm just kind of going off of the top of my head and what I wrote down. So number one is Doc Marten boots. I never made the Christmas haul, but this was something that I got for Christmas, and they are the classic Doc Marten boots. These just literally go with so many of my outfits, and they're just a very versatile shoe. I've been wearing them almost every day, and I have to like remember, like, girl, you own a bunch of other shoes. You have to wear other shoes too. Number two, while we're still on the spectrum of fashion, is definitely red. I mean, obviously February, Valentine's Day, so I was like wearing some red clothes around the week, but then I just couldn't stop. So red everything. I love red tights. I think they're like the cutest trend right now. I absolutely love just like red sweaters. I'm gonna have a red sweater, but I want one. I love painting my nails red. I always do this like dark red, and then I just love the color red. I think anytime I can incorporate it into an outfit, I think it looks so, so cute. The combination of red and black is adorable. Honestly, I feel like my aesthetic this year has been a lot more defined. I've been wearing more like, I don't know, kind of a mix of downtown girl with like some coquette. So I don't know, that's a really weird combination. But something you don't know is I'm a huge Pinterest girl, so my wardrobe is very Pinterest coded as well. Number three is another fashion related item, and these are my Mary Jane heels, or not really heels, but just little platforms. These are the best shoes along with the Docs. I literally love these so, so much. Like I mentioned before, I am a tights girl, so these go so well with all my tights outfits. And they're just these adorable little shoes. They're made by Madden Girl, so that's like the Steve Madden kids collection, I guess, or the teen collection. And I just love them so much. They're so, so cute. Next up, if you are a frequenter of my channel, you know this is coming, the torture poets department. I mean, honestly, this was pretty much like one of the biggest things that happened this month. I mean, this was a huge month for me, just in general. But I'm so excited for the new Taylor Swift album, guys. Like, honestly, I cannot contain it. I'm excited to see what these songs are like. The titles seem so good. And I'm already getting stressed about the merch. And on the topic of poets, another thing I was really into this month, I know I mentioned before Lana Del Rey, and I was really into her poetry album, The Violet Bent Backwards Over the Grass. I was listening to that so much. They have it on podcast on Spotify, and I just think it was really, really good poetry, and so I was listening to that a bunch. I really want to get that album, or not album, but like little collection on vinyl. Another thing on the subject of writing, my next one, is writing myself. So I'm a huge writer, I know I mentioned that before. I love writing stories. I'm kind of working on my novel right now. I love writing songs, I love writing poetry, and I love writing my journal. So this month was just a big month for writing for me. So the next item on my list is not actually a thing, but it's actually just something that happened this month. And that was the French exchange program that happened at my school. So I am learning French. I've been learning French for a couple years now. And so at my school, we have a whole big French class. There's different class periods because there's different levels, but huge French program. And basically we set up something with a high school in Paris where that is has students that are learning English, and basically they came to our school and to where I live for a week, and we had a whole week of fun with these students. People could host them. I didn't host them because I wasn't able to, but it was just great. There were so many friendships that were made. I had so much fun with these kids, and I made like some great bonds that are still happening now, and I'm still emailing them, and it's just so fun. The next item is the Guts Tour, which I went to, and there's gonna be a whole segment in this video talking about that, so stay tuned. But that was amazing. And then finally, I would have to say like Shakespeare and just like that genre of writing in general. I'm part of drama as well. I'm an actress, or an amateur actress or whatever. So I'm part of the drama class at my school, and we went on a field trip to see The Winter's Tale by Shakespeare, and it was super fun. So I've been like kind of enjoying the Shakespeare, and just like he has such interesting writing, and I'm really excited to get to read some more of his works. Oh my gosh. So I just got back from Palm Springs, and I just saw Olivia Rodrigo on opening night of her Guts World Tour, and that was just absolutely incredible. So I'm a huge, huge Olivia Rodrigo fan. If you have seen any of my videos of my record collection hauls, you know that I am a huge, huge Libby. And I actually did see her on her Sour Tour here in Los Angeles at the Greek Theater, and that was amazing. And I'm so, so happy that I was able to see her on her second tour, the Guts Tour, and nonetheless to see her on opening night, like that was absolutely insane. So I live in LA, and so we went out to Palm Springs for the tour, and we went on Friday, which was the day of the concert, and so we got there and it was so exciting. We were in the hotel room getting ready. For my outfit, I wore my Sour Tour shirt, my glittery little skirt, and then purple tights, and then my docs, and I did all my hair, and I did some like a little tattoo here from my Sour Tour tattoo pack. And then I also, like, of course, I was wearing jewelry. I had like my butterfly rings and everything. And then of course, this was a popular item, but everybody was doing like the little red heart necklace that she did in Bad Idea, right? And that was really fun. So like everybody was wearing one of those. And it was very exciting. So at the arena, we saw her at the AquaSure Arena. And it was really cool because there were like these giant like little butterflies hanging everywhere. And then there was also the Guts merch tour truck, which was so cute. And everybody was just like so excited. All the costumes were fun. Everybody was just like buzzing with excitement. They were playing Olivia's songs outside. And they also had these like giant projections, like laser projections on the arena, that was like saying lyrics from her songs. Like, it was so fun. I was like, maybe I can fix him. There was like this butterfly that said Guts on it. Like, I will put some videos up here. But it was very, very cute. And it was very exciting to see that because the last time I saw her, it was at the Greek Theater in LA. And that was a very small venue, very like toned down concert in general. Like the Sour Tour was very, just very raw and very intimate. So we got inside, I got my merch, which I will show later. And then the opening act was Chapel Roan. So before she came on, there was like this projection of these candles on the screen that they said Guts. And basically before she came on, they started like melting. And once they were all blown out and just done, then the concert started. And it was super cool. And she came on. The first song was Bad Idea, right? And it was just so, so exciting. Like, this was a great experience. I've never been to the opening night of a concert before. Nonetheless, such a high-profile concert, like the Guts Tour. So everybody was, like, so excited. Nobody knew it was going to happen with the costumes, the set list, the production, the set, all of it. It was all a surprise for everyone, and it was just so exciting to see all of this come to life for the first time in front of a live audience. And Olivia was also just so excited as well, you could tell. And like I mentioned before, I saw her in the Sour Tour, and it was just so cool to see her again and just see how she's grown and changed as an artist. And there was like such cool choreography, such cool costumes and visuals. The visuals were amazing. And I'm going to do like the photo dump, video dump at the end, but I just wanted to like discuss it first. But just absolutely amazing. The production was so good. So now we're gonna like go through the track list or the set list, and we're gonna talk about the different songs. As mentioned before, she started the concert with Bad Idea, right? I mean, absolutely iconic. We all love that song. And then she did Ballad of a Homeschool Girl. I mean, that is such one of my favorite songs from Guts for sure. I love it so much. And then she did Vampire, which I loved the visuals for that as well. Traitor, Driver's License. Okay, the Teenage Dream performance absolutely definitely made me cry because it was so cute because she put up these visuals of her as a like little 5-year-old, 6-year-old, like young Olivia. And she was like doing her own like little concerts at her house, and it was just so, so cute to see that. And I loved her little speech before it as well. Like her speeches, she was very, very good with the audience. And it's just amazing to see someone be able to just entertain that whole stadium, not stadium, arena full of people, and just be so herself and just have so much fun. Especially she must have been feeling so much pressure and been so much stressed about starting her world tour, and she did amazing. Loved it. And then she went into a different costume. She did Pretty Isn't Pretty, Love Is Embarrassing, Making the Bed. And then for Logical, like this is when the concert just turned into a spectacle. She basically got on this little crescent moon, and she was just like going around the entire little arena. So basically it was like a track. The crescent moon was a track on a track, and she just went around. And it was so pretty. And she stopped around each area of the arena, and she was like waving to everybody, and it was so cute. And then she also did Enough For You on the moon. And then she came down, she did Lacey, and I love Lacey. That's definitely probably one of my favorite Olivia Rodrigo songs of all time. And then she did Jealousy, Jealousy. She did Happier. Okay, this was such a good part as well, because she went and sat down on her stage with her guitar player, and she did a beautiful acoustic rendition of Happier, which that's like literally one of my favorite songs, and Favorite Crime, another one of my favorite songs. I'm so glad she did all the deep cuts from Sour as well, and not just the, you know, hits from Sour. I'm glad she did like, she did almost all of the songs from Sour. So she did all of Guts, and she did almost all of Sour. I think she left out two songs, and she didn't do, She didn't do Hope You're Okay, and she didn't do One Step Forward, Three Steps Back, but she did everything else, and that was amazing. And then she also did Deja Vu, of course, and then she did The Grudge, and she was getting really emotional during that, and it was beautiful. And then she did Brutal, and she did Obsessed. Okay, this was so amazing, because I am, of course, I'm a diehard Livy, so I know the secret tracks. I actually have the secret tracks record, which has the four unreleased, you can't stream them tracks. There's Stranger, there's Obsessed, there's The Girl I've Always Been, and there's Been Scared of My Guitar. And so we have those, and she did Obsessed, and this was amazing because all the real ones in the audience were screaming this song, and I just loved it. And then she ended, not really ended, but she ended the concert with All American Bee, and like this is a bop. I literally love this song so much, and the performance of it was just so good. And there was this part where she screams in the song, and she paused, and she was like, I want everyone to think about someone that really just really annoys you, and you're gonna scream at the top of your lungs. And that was just so fun. This was a therapy session with Olivia. And then so she left the stage, and then we had an encore. And that encore, I've never like gone to a concert and had like a real encore. We're all just chanting for her to come back, and so we were all like, get him back, because that was the only song from the Guts that she hadn't done. So we were just saying that, and she came out, did Good For You, and then she ended with a bang with Get Him Back. And it was just so fun, and just every second of this concert was just so entertaining. Never a dull moment. Each song she really really just performed so well. It was just amazing. I love Olivia so much, and I just, as a girl and as an artist or an aspiring artist, I just find it so amazing to have these role models that I can look up to. Taylor, Olivia, Billy, Lana, just all of them, like, just give me inspiration that I can make art no matter what. I mean, I love writing, I love songwriting, I love music, but just having these people that go out and do it, and just seeing them do things like do this amazing Guts World Tour, is like, I can do this if I work hard. And I just thought that was amazing. And I just absolutely loved the concert so, so much. And just, I'm so happy that I got to go on opening night when it was all a mystery to everyone and the whole world. And just to have had this experience with Olivia that only the people in the stadium could have had on the first night of the Guts World Tour. And I think it was just a great time for everyone in the audience. It was a great time for Olivia. It looked like it, and it was just a really, really fun experience. Not to mention, I was sitting in the section 101, and that is like right behind the VIP section. And I saw Louis, whatever you want to call him, Louis Partridge, her boyfriend there. That was really cool. And then also, of course, Iris Apatow, one of her besties. That was so fun to see her as well. And it's just really cool. After the concert on Saturday, I got to go to Crumble Cookies, and I waited for an hour and a half to get the Guts exclusive World Tour cookie, which basically each stop on the tour she is putting out for 1 week at Crumble Cookies, the Guts cookie, and I will put a picture of it up here, as well as my own footage later. But that was so fun. We waited for a while, but we got it, and it was fun. Everybody was wearing their shirts, and we were all waiting. It did take a while, but it was worth it. Delicious cookie. And then we went to Joshua Tree after. And so it was just a whole fun trip. And I'm so happy that I had this experience. So now I'm going to show you the merch that I got, and then we're going to go through the photos. So if you guys have seen my channel before, even just any of my videos, you guys know I'm a merch girl through and through. I'm already getting stressed out because of the Tortured Poets Department coming out. And I'm like, where is the money for this? Because I know there's going to be such good merch, and I know I'm getting sidetracked here, but like, these records that are coming out for Tortured Poets Department, like, I need those, but hopefully we'll get them. But anyway, so of course for the Guts tour, I was like ready to get the merch, and I got some, so let's go ahead and check it out. So first of all, this was like the big item at the tour. I mean, it's just adorable. Everybody wanted to snatch this up, and I did as well. I've already had my eyes on this for a while because she released it on her website. But it is the butterfly tote, and like, this is just the cutest thing I've ever seen in my life. Literally, so cute. I'm a big tote bag girl. I love my Taylor Swift totes. I have record store totes. I have just totes in general. I love totes. But this, I mean, this is so unique. It's literally a butterfly. And of course, we all know Olivia loves her butterflies. And so I had to get this, of course. I think I got this for my birthday. Like, I think my mom bought it for me to save for my birthday. But of course, I'm gonna show it to you guys on my channel. And it's just so pretty. I mean, love it so much. So now let's see what else we got. And it has like a little metal to close it, little magnet. And so inside we have my shirts. So I got the classic Guts Tour shirt, which has the logo, or not the logo, but like the look for the tour. Like, this is the face of the tour. And so we have this, it's so cute. It says "Spill Your Guts Live on Tour," and I sure did. It's so such a cute design. I love the stars. I like really like how she did like the like astrological kind of vibe for the tour, because like honestly, I've mentioned this before, I already went a whole rant about it, but that crescent moon flying over the audience, literally just amazing. And then on the back we have all of our tour dates. I am the first one, of course, and it's just so cute. I can't wait to wear this and style this. I went to the concert on Friday, of course, and I get to go back to school and be like, yeah, Guts Tour. But then the next shirt that I got is super, super cute as well, because I don't have any shirts like this. I usually just get like the baggy t-shirts, I don't know, but I'm experimenting. And we got this kind of like little baby tee sort of thing, and it's like so, so cute. It's kind of got the ringer vibe because it has the ringer on the shoulders, and not the shoulders, the neck and the sleeves, but it's blue, not blue. I'm literally losing my mind. Like, what am I talking about? Purple and black. And then we have the logo design here, and it's like so cute. It says Guts and it's adorable. It says OR. It has her logo on the sleeve, OR. And I just can't wait to style these. I might like show you guys later my styling for this, but I'm super excited for that. And then we also got the poster, so let me show you that. Here is the poster, and it says Guts World Tour, and then we got this lovely toilet, and we have all the stars in there, and it says Olivia Rodrigo with the tour dates on her t-shirt. And there's actually like kind of iridescent shiny detailing on this. So for example, like the guts part is literally shining. It's just so pretty. I think the merch was really cute, and I'm super happy with what I got, so loved that. So now I'm going to be showing you guys the full photo dump, video dump, the whole like little vlog from the concert, so I hope you guys enjoy. I'm alright with the movie star.